Sir, I'm here not to talk of me, but of your extraordinary farewell address you've written. I hope this version that I prepared for your consideration captures your true spirit.
Thank you, Alex, for all of your hard work on this. Friends and fellow citizens, where's my opening?
Oh, the opening about all the abuses in the newspapers, yet you'll pass over them in utter silence?
I mean, I sounded like some frantic, beleaguered old warrior who must, as he retires, face his enemy with his sword slashing, indulging in wounded pride? God, I have you, Alex, to rid this of those unconscious egotisms. Hope to observe a virtuous nation continuing the blessings that would encourage nations throughout the world to seek a similar liberty.
You've said it many times, sir.
Have I?
Yes.
Then it's excellent.
Yes, I know.
No, this I'd cut this out here. This smacks too much of affected modesty. And make this here more to the point. Since the Constitution is a rock on which union rests, no branch of government should encroach on any other. Only experience, the surest standard.
Oh, no, sir, I think it's much stronger if, yes, if.
Experience.
You're absolutely right, sir.
Kept my warning against partisan politics. Political contention is a fire not easily put out. We must guard against it, for instead of warming, it could destroy us.
Hear, hear.
Why should the United States entangle our peace and prosperity in the toils of European ambition, rivalship, interest, humor, our caprice?
A new declaration of independence from Europe.
Yes. Yes. Now you're being too gentle with me here. So you shouldn't have kept this about my not being moved by ambition or lust for power.
But it's true.
No. And that I'd not gained but lost money in government service?
Sir, you have not.
Take it out, it's vanity. You kept the final words. I anticipate with pleasing expectation a retirement in which I can enjoy, in the midst of my fellow citizens, the benign influence of good laws under a free government, the happy reward of our mutual cares, labors, and dangers. Here in Philadelphia for the two terms of my presidency, and you have served us very well. And now it's time to go home. Mrs. Washington and I, in gratitude for all that you've done, have decided to leave you here in the city, thereby granting you your freedom under Pennsylvania law.
Mr. Washington, I thank you.
There's a wonderful man here named Richard Allen, and a group of your own people called the Free African Society will find employment for you as freed men and women. Christopher will give you an envelope tomorrow with money in it to help you in your your new way of life.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, well, we can talk tomorrow.
Excuse me, sir.
I've been thinking. I want to go back with you to Mount Vernon. I want to be with you to the end of your days.
To believe your last night as president. You look sad. Lonely.
If I am, it's because I don't understand. I tried my best to serve well. I wanted to leave behind a people working together peacefully. And all we do is fight. We fight. I'm not sure we'll even survive. I failed, Martha. I failed.
Forget the newspaper slanders. Forget the angry voices. Remember only that for all of your life, in peace and war, you've done what your conscience told you must be done for the greater good of your country. It matters not what some of the people might think. It matters only that you know what you've accomplished. You brought this nation into being. You preserved its freedom. You kept it out of war. God knows, Mr. Washington, you've not failed. You've done magnificently.
President-elect John Adams.
How long has the president been waiting?
I'm not sure, sir. But I hear he walked here alone.
Mr. President, this is the day.
You're still officially president, sir.
Not for long. I'm nearly out. You're nearly in. See which of us will be the happiest.
The Chief Justice is ready, Mr. President.
Yeah, it seems like only yesterday. Something I'll never forget, I'll tell you. I'll never forget it.
Remember
Trenton? Oh, marching through the cold and dark.
And the sleet wet our powder so our muskets wouldn't fire. And we were wondering what the devil we were going to do. And the general says, use your steel!
And give it all possible success and duration consistent with the ends of his providence.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
I believe this is the most satisfying moment of my career. The torch has been passed without violence, not to a king.
Yes, Mr. President, I agree with you. After you, Mr. President.
Oh, no. I'm a private citizen now. Mr. Vice President.
A visit to historic Mount Vernon, the home of George Washington, located just outside Washington, D.C. For publications about George Washington, write to the Mount Vernon Ladies Association, Mount Vernon, Virginia, 22121.